This is a Tempo special report.
According to the Department of Justice, there are more than 800,000 gang members who belong to over 30,000 gangs across the United States, some of whom call Eastern Pennsylvania home. Alice Massimi takes a look at the life of a gangster who now calls the Northampton County Correctional Facility home and explores the growing gang problem across our region.
It's 11 o'clock on a weeknight, and you'd think the streets of Allentown would be empty. But that's not the case.
This is a regular occurrence all day long, all night long. More than half don't have jobs. They just hang out. A lot of them sell drugs.
Teenagers play basketball. Children roam the streets. And the cries of a baby echo down an alleyway. Police say it's a breeding ground for gangs and crime.
People get that perception of gang members as being bad. It's
not an environment gang member Darnell Walker of the Crips felt at home in. But after getting caught selling drugs in Easton, the 23-year-old has a new home, Northampton County Prison.
Yeah, I saw a couple of people, but it was all what we had to do. I mean, some was for, like, protecting our hood, I mean, retaliation, stuff like that.
Dealing drugs since he was 13, Darnell had already been in and out of jail. When at the age of 16, he decided to join the Crips.
It was there at the time I was young, so I just did it. I didn't think about it. I mean, the money is always good.
Growing up in Newark's projects, Darnell says his dad wasn't around and his mom was always strung out on drugs. So he turned to dealing crack cocaine to support his brother and sisters.
It's not no movie, it's real life. Just taking that risk, being on the edge, you never know what's next. And you just really just being in your hood, looking out for your people, you know what I'm saying?
Do you value your life?
Yeah, of course.
Do you value other people's lives?
It all depends on who they are. Like, if you're a stranger, you don't mean nothing to me.
Even in jail, Darnell hasn't escaped gang life.
Recruiting happens all the time within the prison. We have Bloods recruiting new Bloods, Crips recruiting new Crips all the time in here. Once they come into prison, the life doesn't stop. The life just continues.
Prison gang liaison Jason Worley says as many as 22% of the current population at Northampton County Prison are believed to be in gangs. That high percentage is mirrored out on the streets in many cities throughout eastern Pennsylvania.
We've been receiving for years anecdotal information about the intrusion of some national gangs in each of these cities along the 222 corridor. For the most part, we're getting information of the creepage of the Blood and the Crip culture in each of these areas.
A serious enough problem that the Department of Justice is devoting money to the effort. Under the 222 Corridor Anti-Gang Initiative, Bethlehem will receive $100,000, Easton $140,000, and Allentown will get $200,000 to fight their growing gang problems. Barrett explains it's a three-pronged approach, including law enforcement, prevention, and prison reentry. Cities like Easton say the help couldn't come at a better time.
As far as numbers, we have a fairly large gang problem. The Bloods make up the majority of our problem that we've seen between drug-related crimes and shootings.
On this afternoon, we drive the streets of Easton with Detective Tom Beiser.
This is 6th and Northampton. This has been a huge problem area for us.
Most of what we see is a lot of drug dealing. They join up with one another and sell drugs.
And with that drug dealing comes violence. Beiser says most of the shootings and homicides in the city are gang-related. Many of the suspects and victims are from New Jersey and New York.
They can make more here than they could in New York. They might sell the same rock of crack cocaine here for $20 that they would sell in New York for $5 to $10.
Bethlehem Police Commissioner Randall Miller says the presence of gangs has increased over the past 5 years in his city, too.
It's definitely here. We've been aware of it for a while. We're doing everything we can to keep an eye on not only the signs and to see if it's progressing or we're making a dent on it.
While Bethlehem's gang situation isn't among the worst along the corridor, they still have their share of gang activity.
The Latin Kings, I would say, the most prevalent gang because we have a very high Hispanic community. One of the major things, obviously, is the tagging or the spray painting, They want to try to take over a neighborhood. They want to show that this is their neighborhood or their turf if they're selling drugs. I mean, that's part of it. They also have, obviously, their own color and signage.
In addition to wearing specific clothing and also colors, the gangs let their presence be known through things like the graffiti right here. This graffiti was left by the Bloods on the side of a garage right behind Central Catholic High School in Allentown. In addition to patrolling high crime areas, Sergeant Dorney and the rest of the power shift keep an eye on suspected drug dealers and gang members.
The biggest problem is the violence that's associated with it and the firepower that they have to commit that violence with.
There are 10 known gangs in Allentown. Police say they're responsible for everything from homicides to assaults to theft.
The violence just scares people. There seems to be a less of a degree of respect for life. We see gang members and drug dealers pulling a gun out for what we would, you or I would probably characterize as a minor disagreement, and somebody winds up getting shot and or killed.
Police say citizens can help fight gang violence too by reporting any suspicious activity.
What kind of gangs you hear of? Do you know of? The Bloods, Crips? What about Latin Kings, Nietas?
Experts want other young people to make better choices than Darnell so they stay off the streets and out of jail. For Tempo, I'm Alice Messini reporting. We'll be right back.